So there's a harsh unwanted shadow right on your subject and you've tried everything to remove it, from channels to blend modes to blend diff to color range, but nothing worked. Well, this is the technique for you. And there's two simple steps. Number one, fix the brightness, and number two, fix the color. And that's it. So without any further ado, let's get started. World of Photoshop, and to download this photo and follow along, check the links in the description. So let's start with fixing the brightness. But before we do anything, keep in mind, we don't want to be distracted by the colors. So let's take the colors away by using a check layer. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then create a solid color adjustment layer. You might be thinking, why am I not just decreasing the saturation and making it black and white? Well, there's a reason for it. If we choose any color, any color which has no color in it, in other words, white, gray, or black, anything like that, just hit OK and change the blend mode from normal to color. Right now, the color has been taken away and you only see the brightness levels. Why is this accurate and not decreasing the saturation? Let me just demonstrate something. So if we simply create a gradient, I've already shown this to you before in previous videos. So if you click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose a gradient, and let's choose a gradient of a rainbow. Single click on in here, and we're going to choose something like this. So this is a rainbow. Hit OK. Now, keep in mind, all of the colors here, if I just go to the color picker, have a look, all of the colors have brightness level of what? 100. So technically, they are at the same brightness level, right? And if you check red, brightness level 100, right? Same brightness level, technically. Now, if you hit OK again. Now, if you simply create a hue saturation adjustment layer on top by clicking on the adjustment layer and choosing hue saturation and taking the saturation down, it will become gray because all of them were technically at the same brightness level. But there's a problem with that. If you look at the human eye doesn't perceive things that way. For a human eye, this blue is darker than this yellow. For a human eye, this red is darker than this yellow. So instead of going that route, which deals with light technically, I mean, logically it's right, but to human perception, if you just create a solid color adjustment layer like we just did at the top and change the blend mode to color, it will be more accurate in terms of human perception. Let's turn it on and have a look. As you can see, the blues are darker, right? The reds are darker than the yellows, which makes more sense. That is why it is more accurate to do it this way instead of just taking away the saturation. So this is a simple luminosity check layer. Let's name this luminosity check. Now we need one more check layer to see the differences even more. Let's create a curves adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. If you want to make the shadows more darker to see more differences, so with the hand tool selected, just click and drag down the shadows. Now we want these areas to be normal, click and drag them up. This is just to see the differences better. So these two are check layers. Let's select both of them. Select the first one, hold the Control or Command, select the second one, and then press Control or Command G. Now that the distractions are gone, we are ready to remove the shadows. So select the background layer, and on top of that, we're going to create a curves adjustment layer. Click on the adjustment layer icon, and then choose curves. And we're going to name this brighten. Or you can name this dodge if you want to sound technical. Let's zoom in. All we got to do is to click a point in the middle, take it up, just like that. Now, select the mask, press Control or Command I to invert the mask. Now, what is the concept of mask? White are the areas which show up, black are the areas which hide. So right now the complete mask is black, so the effect of curves is showing nowhere. As soon as we take a brush and paint white, the effect of curves will begin to show in that area. All right, so select the mask and then just zoom in, take a soft brush. So here at the top, soft round brush, and with a low flow, start painting on the shadow. Now, if you have a Wacom tablet, it will make the process extremely simple for you because then you can paint softer for less intensity on areas with lighter shadows and paint harder for more intensity on areas with darker shadows. So let me show you what I mean by that. So you can set the opacity or the flow to pen pressure by going to Window and then Brush Settings. With the same brush selected, you can just check Transfer. And inside of Transfer, we don't want any jitter, just decrease the jitter. And we want to set the opacity to pen pressure, and we also want to set the flow to pen pressure as well. Make sure you decrease the minimum to 0%, and then you just paint softer. See, at these areas, the shadows are not very dark, so we need to paint softer. And for the dark areas, just paint harder. That's it. So you don't have to paint multiple times. You can actually use the pressure of your hand to control how much shadows you want to remove. So if you're using a tablet like me, you can set the flow to about 5 to 10% and then using the pressure of your hand, control the intensity. If you're not using a tablet, set the flow from 1 to 2% and then paint more times in that area to have more intensity. All right, so I'm gonna set it to 5%. 5% is fine for me. And then just start painting. I'm gonna speed up the process so that it doesn't get monotonous. Just simply paint. Now, as you can see, we have finished brightening up the shadows using this curves. Let's have a look at the before and after. So this is the before. Actually, this is the after. This is the before. Shadow is all over her face, right? And if I turn it on, have a look at it. Such a dramatic difference. But before we move on to step number two, which is fixing the color, have a closer look. There is still a little bit of shadow. It is soft, as you can see right here. How do we take care of that? It's very simple. All we gotta do is to use Blend If. Now, let me ask you one question. What is the common property of a shadow? It is dark, right? And we can limit brightening in the dark areas by using Blend If. So let's create one more curves adjustment layer by clicking on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Now we're gonna brighten it, click a point in the middle, and then take it up, just like this. Now, to limit it just to the shadows, which is a dark area, double click on the right hand side of the layer. This opens up the layer styles dialog box. Now inside of that, take the slider of the underlying layer from right to left. We are taking away the brightening from the bright areas of the underlying layer or the layer which is under it, which is the subject layer. All right, so we're going to take it away. As you can see, it's very harsh, so we need to break the slider. Hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac, click on the slider to break it apart and take it to the extremes. We want it extremely soft. Hit OK. Right there. Now, we don't want it all over the image. It's doing a great job, but only on the face and the shadow areas, right? So what do we do now? Mask it. So click on the mask, press Ctrl or Command I to invert the mask. Take the brush, white as the foreground color. With a soft brush, you can also decrease the flow if you want to 20%. Just start painting on the soft shadow areas. See how easily we are taking care of it? That was not hard, right? This area also has a little bit of shadow. All right, now have a look. Here's the before, here's the after. Let's make it soft. Now, let's remove the shadow under the eyebrows and the eyes. So we're gonna paint right there. Now that looks interesting. Let me show you the before and after. Here's the before, here is the after. Let's paint a little bit here. Now, if you think it's too much, you can always do this. Decrease the opacity. So let's control it accordingly. We don't want it totally gone. Probably somewhere about 92 would be great. Now, we have come a long way, isn't it? So here is the before. Let me show you without all of these. This is the before. This is the after. Fantastic, isn't it? Time for us to move to step number 2, where we fix the color. So before we fix the color, we need to see the color. So let's hide or remove the check layer. This check layer, this group was just to take away the colors and make the shadows extreme so they are more visible, hence more easy to remove. Now we don't need it, so we can actually turn it off or simply delete it. If we zoom in, the color might not be consistent. Have a look right here. The areas where we remove the shadows, this is the before, this is the after, the color is a little off as compared to the rest of the areas. Here as well, the color would be a little off, as you can see in this area. Again, if we just zoom in into a couple of areas like this, the color would be a little off. This area as well, the color is off. So how do we fix that? Very simple, create a new layer. Click on the new layer button and you can actually name this color fix, right? And change the blend mode from normal to color because we want to fix the color. Choose that. Now take the brush. Make sure it is a soft brush. You can always decrease the flow if you want to, but I'm going to keep it in this case about 40%. And then all you got to do is to take a sample and paint. That's it. Now, before you start painting, just make sure, click on the eyedropper tool, just make sure sample current and below or all layers is selected. And 3x3 average is fine, but I'm going to increase it to probably 5x5 so that it takes an average of 5x5 pixels. So it creates a box of 5x5 and takes an average of all of those colors. This prevents you from accidentally sampling a color which might not be the right representation. Maybe you sampled a noise. We don't want to do that. Right, so take the brush back again and take a sample and just paint on the areas where you think the colors are off. Take a sample from an area nearby and just paint on that. This is just to match the colors around. So let me show you the before and after. This is the before, this is the after. Very minute difference. I'm not sure if you can notice this or not. You'll be able to notice this here. Have a look, the colors are a little too saturated. So we're gonna take a sample from here and paint over that. Look, here's the before, here's the after. It took care of it. Take a sample from here and paint over that. That area is gone now. All right, that was not the right color. Sometimes you might have to sample from different places and try what fits the best. I think that is a little too desaturated. We're gonna have to sample from a darker area, maybe something like this, and try painting here. Yes, that works. Still, let's decrease the flow to 20% and let's try painting. All right, that kind of goes pretty nicely. Let's have a look at the before and after, if it fits nicely or not. Here's the before, here's the after. We took care of that. Now let's have a look here. Too much saturation. We're going to take a sample and paint. Taken care of. That is great. Now here as well, see that patch right there? Take a sample and paint. No problem, we took care of that. And now here, some extra saturation. Take a sample and paint. Take a sample from a dark area and paint. All right, here as well, we're gonna take a sample from a nearby area and paint. Just dim it down a little bit. Take a sample and paint. Whenever you see too much saturation, just take a sample from a nearby area of the same brightness level, which looks good, and then paint. All right, that looks to be nice. Let's have a look at the before and after. Here's the before, here's the after. Very minute difference. I'm not really sure if you can see it. If you look at these areas where the colors were off, here's the before. Look, the color was too saturated right there. And if you turn it on, it fixes that. Now, check for any color irregularities here and there, because when you remove the shadows, you're gonna see a lot of them. All is fine, all looks good. Now, let's have a complete look at the before and after. So here is the before, here is the after. Isn't that amazing? So again, before, after. Wow, wonderful. As you can see how simple that was to remove harsh shadows in Photoshop. However, you do need a little bit of practice to paint on the shadows. Now, just a quick little recap. All you gotta do is to create a curves adjustment layer, click and make a point in the middle, take it up to brighten it all up. But we wanna limit the brightening just to the shadows. So what do? We create a negative mask. So select the mask and turn it all black. Now, with the brush, with a soft brush, just start painting on the shadows. If you're using a Wacom tablet, you can set the opacity and flow to pen pressure and paint harder for more intensity on the areas with darker shadows and paint softer for less intensity on areas with lighter shadows. Once you have done that, you can actually create one more curves adjustment layer to take care of the soft shadow areas. And you can easily use Blend If to target the dark areas only. On top of that, you can go to step number 2, which is fixing the color. Because sometimes when you raise the shadows, when you brighten up the shadows, there's going to be a color mismatch. So you can simply create a new layer, change the blend mode to color, take sample from around the place where the colors have mismatched or the colors have gone wrong, just paint over it. That's it. That's all you got to do. I hope this video helped you. And if it did, make sure to give us a like. And also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you don't miss any other feature tip, trick, or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thank you for all your support. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.